The Build Modifier is a simple but awesome tool that allows you to animate the construction or deconstruction of your object. To start off, I'm going to add a cube, so I'll press Shift A and then under Mesh, I'm going to choose Cube. Then I'm going to left click my blue spanner here to go into Modifier Properties. Then I can just press plus Add Modifier. Then under Generate, I can just choose this Build option. Here we'll have a start frame and a length. Length determines the number of frames that the animation will have, and start frame will choose where the animation starts. This can be handy if you want the animation to start at a later point in the timeline. If I press space to play the animation, you can see it's going to start slowly constructing our object. If I was to set this to start frame to 20, for example, now if I play my animation, you'll notice construction only starts once it hits frame 20. So a very handy feature. I'll set this start frame back to 1. To better understand the length, I'm just going to change this to 20. And now if I press the space bar, you can see that it only takes 20 frames in order to get our construction complete. This reverse button will allow us to deconstruct our object. So if I left click this, come back to the start, you'll see our object starts completely built. And then if I press the space bar, it'll quickly deconstruct it in 20 frames. Randomize, if I left click to check the box and come back to the start and press play, will make it so random vertices will disappear. This works with the deconstruction as well, which is handy. Although at the moment, it's kind of hard to see this as full effect because we don't have a lot of geometry. So I'll press tab and that's going to take us into edit mode. Then I'm going to press A and then I'm going to right click and choose subdivide. What A done was select all and then subdivide has now turned all these faces into 4 more faces. Then I'll open this subdivide box here and where it says number of cuts, I can maybe increase this number to somewhere much higher. I'll maybe go with 9. Now if I press tab to come back into object mode and press play, you can see it's got much more to deal with now. And if I turn off this randomize, you'll see it's going to start doing it in a much more methodical way. So this randomize can be a really cool tool. Since we've got more geometry, I'll try it on a different length, like 100, like that. And then when I put on randomize, it's going to happen randomly like that. Also in randomize, there's a seed. The seed will just be a random variation of the randomness, so you can get even more adjustments. For example, if you had 2 different cubes, you might want them to be constructed randomly in a different way, so the seed can be handy for that. This build modifier is really cool and handy, but if you want to learn more about modifiers in depth, make sure to check out this playlist here to learn about more modifiers in depth. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.